What if we looked for love and peace and laughter instead of war? What if we went through life looking for the pearls of wisdom and beauty instead of the worst? What amazing experiences could we find and nurture? Imagine.
We have a special guest this evening, Richard Blomquist and Hart Young. These two friends came together and founded the Paso Peace Community. These two men began basically as boys on opposite sides of the war, and now they're working together for peace.
Oh my goodness, I think I have to wash hands after this.
Richard Blomquist, and I've been living in Paso Robles now 20 years.
My name is Hart Junger, and I was born in Germany outside the city of Dresden. And I was 7 years old when that city was wiped out by Anglo-American bombers.
My goodness.
Yes, and three bombs fell into the suburb where we lived. But we were not hit and are very grateful.
I had completed my bombing combat tour in 44, so I didn't have anything to do with the bombing of Dresden. And of course, we didn't cover that part of the Europe from Italy. That was 8th Air Force and then in the British Air Force, yes. Yeah.
How did you meet?
Well, that is a story in itself. Hart's daughter helped my oldest daughter taking care of my wife in her last days. She told me about her father who experienced the bombing of Dresden. I was very interested in his story. And she then told her father, and then, well, just how did that go?
Right. I mean, Dick, I guess, wanted to apologize for the damage he did during the war with being a bomber pilot.
What did you think about that?
He wanted to apologize and wanted me to forgive, which I gladly did, since I wanted to work towards peace.
I'm interested in the story because I'm writing a book, and in that I felt it would be part of the book because instead of a war story, it has become more of a peace story. It has become very, very much in my life. And the work we've done now is, which has become Paso Peace Circle. And it was originated by Hart because when he came here, he wanted to start a peace circle. Now it's evolved into Paso Peace Community.
Veterans for Peace. You know, I was prepared to fly a bomber airplane that dropped tons of bombs and destroyed property and lives. I met another man that was on the receiving end, and it happened to be in Dresden, Germany. And he now lives in Paso Robles, and we were meeting on a weekly basis for about 6 years, and developed eventually what is now the Paso community, the peace community. And of course, it's being taken up by Art and some of the others now, and Paul Fairchild is kind of taking over the publicity. So that's part of the peace program that they have. There are many voices for peace, and I think the veterans play a very important part in it, and what there are ripples being sent out by these peace voices. Now we hope they can be joined in harmony and develop a tidal wave that covers the world. Thank you.
Yes, dear friends, Dick Blomqvist was a bomber pilot, but it was other people in the airplane who would decide where to send the bombs down. So, and that was first in Russia, actually, where they wanted to defeat the German front lines. And I was a child in Dresden. And when Dick's wife passed away in 2012, my daughter, as a medical assistant, helped as much as she could. And through her, Dick and I came to know each other and became friends. So, no more war, but Paso Peace Community, an effort to not start wars, but to get together with the other peace communities in the area. There are quite a few, quite a number, and there is no peace dictator. We all meet in small groups, and this way hope to promote peace in here and in the United States and in the world.
Yes.
Hart being a priest, and I had a background of a biblical background, you might say, that to some extent. So I was interested also in a faith in that respect. So that became part of our conversations, along with some of the story.
I have to say that in first grade we greeted our teacher with Heil Hitler.
Really?
And after the war, when the Nazis were gone, we had pictures of Marx, Engels, Lenin and Stalin in every school. Our new saints.
It actually started when I was in high school, you might say. We were starting to hear about this man over in Germany kind of taking over. His name was Hitler. And so that was kind of in the background. Then, of course, there's quite a bit happened as far as my life is concerned. And in 1941, the United States was furnishing war materials for the Germany, or that is for Britain, and I think to start with was France, of course, then France was conquered quickly. But anyway, they were sending ships over with supplies, and the Germans were torpedoing them. And so it was very evident that we were going to be involved in a war. So in 1941, I enlisted as an airplane mechanic. And after completing that training, I was waiting for an assignment, and then Pearl Harbor happened.
You know, I mean, we had experienced war, we had experienced the end of the war, we had experienced peace. We were in the Russian zone, not so happy with the Russians, but we begged them for bread that was baked at German bakeries, and that was nice of them. But we also liked, or we dreamt of West Germany. My father had been a Nazi, not surprising, and he came back from the British zone and walked to Dresden in the Russian zone and found work to rebuild a bridge over the Elbe River. And from there, they caught him as a former Nazi. So he spent 2 years in a concentration camp in Mühlberg on the Elbe River. So he came home in 1950, and we were happy because he liked to go hiking, and we all liked hiking in the beautiful mountain range of the Elbsandsteingebirge. We moved to a city near town near Stuttgart, and there our parents sent all three of us to the Waldorf School. Yes, I mean, the idea of the Waldorf School is bring out what is hidden inside the children, bring out their talents.
Is that where you discovered art?
And I had been good at drawing and painting in East Germany. And another idea was, what do we do together when we meet? And we made a nice big collage.
But then, of course, Hart brought his little stand with a bunch of drawers in with all colored paper and handed out to the different ones of us. And we were supposed to cut and paste. And
what did you think of that, doing art?
Well, it was very new to me.
What I have here tonight is to honor your friendship that you have formed, coming from war and finding peace in Paso Robles. I'd like to present both Hart and Richard with a certificate of special congressional recognition in recognition of outstanding and invaluable service to the community by creating the Paso Robles Peace Community. Thank you.
Get people to come on board with your mission?
You mean?
We just asked them. So we tried to contact speakers of different religions, different cultures, you know. And one was Paul K. Chappelle. Having been a veteran himself with experiencing PTSD and overcoming some matters of rage and so forth, and becoming a peace advocate that's so strong.
You know, we advertised our ideas and our meetings, which we wanted to have once a month, one Sunday each month. So we advertised it at the Plymouth Congregational Church and at St. James Episcopal Church. And the Episcopalian said, yes, you can use our community room for his talk. 80 people came and wanted to hear him.
Wow.
And that was quite impressive.
You could give some advice to young people.
Well, it's something that is very personal. And Hart and I have talked about this too, and that is it starts within each one.
Within inside a person?
Yes, it's in our hearts, you might say. Mm. Yes.
And to work for outer peace without being able to find inner peace.
It's
That's also important. Mm-hmm. I mean, to find inner peace so that we can promote peace of souls.
A war poem written by a buddy of Louis Dinor, Williamsport, Pennsylvania. What did you see, soldier? What did you see at war? I saw such glory and horror that man never saw before. I saw men's hearts burn naked in red crucibles of pain. I saw such godlike courage as I'll never see again. What did you think, soldier? What did you think at war? I thought how we had not learned from wars or waits before, except new ways of killing, new multiples of pain, and all the blood that men have shed is blood that's shed in vain. What did you learn, soldier? What did you learn at war? I learned that we must learn something we have never learned before. That victories won on battlefields are victories won in vain, unless in peace we kill the Germans that breed fresh wars again. What did you pray for, soldier? What did you pray for at war? I pray that we might do the things we have not done before, that we might mobilize for peace, nor mobilize in vain, lest Christ and vanity forced to climb, start Calvary again.
Meeting and you guys sing.
Yeah.
That's it?
Yeah.
Can I hear a little bit?
Yes.
I tried.
Okay,
this is my song, O God of all the nations, a song of peace for lands afar and mine. This is my home, the country where my heart is. Here are my hopes, my dreams, my holy shrine. But other hearts in other lands are beating with hopes and dreams as true and high as mine. That's it.